Hello everybody, I'm recording now. What a process. You will see if I'm able to figure out how to put in the bloopers. Holy moly. I had my new fancy microphone not even fully plugged in. So you'll see I'm rattling off and I get excited that I figured out how to record. Anyway, so yes, it has been a while since I've been here. I accidentally, my previous laptop, it's a black keyboard, and so I had a black pen, didn't realize, closed it shut, and shattered the screen, the monitor. So, I am now up and running again, although I had to re-record a lot of things, but I mean, it wasn't anything that did not need. It had to be re-recorded because you don't keep posting the same videos over and over again, right? But anyway, I hope everyone is doing well. Yes, last week, started Wella Wisdom's text messages back up again. So those will be coming every Sunday and every Wednesday to start off your week and catch you at that midpoint to kind of zhuzh things up and give you the kick if needed. I know a lot of the times I need a kick myself sometimes. I have, for the last few weeks, aside from my laptop being kind of wonky or just completely inoperable, I took on two new projects that I was super excited about. Oh my gosh, so excited about. And now I'm just like, oh my gosh, what was I thinking? It's call it maturity. It's definitely not a midlife crisis, and which makes me say, I have to say this, midlife. All right, first of all, who are they to determine that in your 50s that's called midlife? Because folks are living way older. Folks are living a lot longer these days. And also, it's not a crisis. You're maturing and less tolerant for things that you put up with or felt the need to put up with. There's a lot of people that, oh gosh, my hair. There's a lot of people that stay married for the kids and, what would the neighbors say if we broke up? Or, oh my gosh, you're single? What? You're in your 50s and you've never had children? Like all of these different social, all this crap. All these titles of things that you're supposed to be doing, and it's just a whole bunch of nonsense. Nonsense, I tell ya. For me, I am on here literally as well as wisdom, because I am sharing the do-overs that I am able to do over with my grandchildren. I am literally, as a grandparent, all other grandparents can tell you, you are literally living the life with the mindset of, I wish I knew then what I know now. Not just with children, but with maturity and experience and the way things are thought out. And such a great place to be. And, well, I should say this. It's a great place to be if you are willing to be accountable for the actions that you're taking. It could be a miserable place if you're too worried about what so-and-so is going to think if you do this, and what's this one going to think if you do that. Look, if this one and that one are not gonna lose their, well, I don't know. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it for anyone. I love my family. I love my circle of support, which is not all family. I have a circle of support that encompasses various different levels of people and experiences, and just it's a circle of people that work for me. And the circle is purposely, by choice, by my choice, getting smaller. As I get older, and again, less tolerant of certain things. If there's one thing that quarantine and COVID taught a lot of people, is we need to live the retired life now. And I'm not saying walk out of your job and this is like the great resignation. I'm not saying any of that. Although, if you could do that, hey, why not? What I am saying is, we need to live our lives with purpose. Like, legit live with purpose. Every single day, every single moment, our experiences are by choice. How we choose to receive information, how we choose to be accountable or not accountable, how we choose to gaslight, deflect, always blame somebody else for why things are not going our way. It's tiring when you as an individual are seeking for yourself to move things forward, to move things in a positive direction. And when I say my circle is getting smaller, it's not getting smaller because I'm getting rid of people. I don't get rid of people. I'm not God. But I am socializing less with individuals who drain my energy, with individuals who it takes too much of me to tolerate them. I'm just less tolerant. Hell, I'm getting too old for some of this crap. I mean, look, I wanna, my goal has always been to retire early. There's Sparky. I always wanted to retire by the time I was 55. That gives me 4 years. And when I say retire, I mean from corporate America, from what I've been doing the last 30 years. That's still my goal. I would love to do it sooner if I had the financial means to do so. But I'm not really sure. I'm not really sure if that's the move. I know what I want my future to look like. I know what I want my, what I need my retirement lifestyle to be. And that's something that I'm working towards each and every day. And so, long term, my long term is in 4 years, 22 to be, in March of 26, maybe 27, because I like odd numbers, which would mean maybe 25. Why not? But in any event, live your lives. Live with purpose. Live with what makes you happy. We need to learn how to listen to our children. Listen. Listen to them. To our children, to our grandchildren. They have a lot to say. Kids are people too. Well, children are people too. Kids are baby goats. I digress. But we as individuals, as the adults in the lives of these young ones, have a responsibility to lead by example. The saying of do as I say, not as I do, it's great for the ego, but it's not great for cutting those chain cycles of crap and nonsense. It's really simple. It just means knowing that your circle of friends, circle of family, are gonna say, oh, what's wrong with you? Oh, why are you changing? Why are you this? Why are you that? Because it makes me happy. Why don't you join me? Oh, no, I don't want to worry about this one. And this one's going to say this. And oh, people going to think you crazy. Oh, no, you can't do that. Mija, tú no puedes hacer eso. Watch me. Or this eye. Watch me. Yep. Right, God? Mm-hmm. Watch me. I will do my best to be my best and to help others help themselves. And that's what I'm going to do. So, that's it. Enjoy the rest of the video. I hope you enjoyed some of the cafe in the beginning. And no, I don't have rice with coffee. No, I don't do that. But I did have the rice with with the vegetables. That's good stuff. This is it feels good to be here again. It feels good to share parts of my journey. And I hope I inspire someone to do what makes them happy. It's good stuff. I'm gonna have, just watch. I'm not gonna say what I'm gonna have. I'm just gonna do it. I'm just gonna do and record it so that you see what I'm doing. All right. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the video, and that's it. Be safe, be well, be kind, and be the best you could be. It's the way the good Lord made you. Okay, bye.
From the sky to the sea, to the air that we breathe, from the depths of the earth to the stars. Looking at the endless star-filled sky, the world is ours. The world is ours.
The world, the world, the world is ours.
Testing video mic testing 3472 7692 FGZBF.